Meets the Stars from Lou Grant, Robert Walden, Brent Summers, Charles Nelson Riley, Audrey Lander, Bert Conley, and Patty Newcastle as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 79. And now, here's the star of Match Game 79, Gene Rader.
Thank you, Johnny O. Friends, hello there. Nice of you to join us, and nice of you to join us, too. Are you ready?
Yes.
Okay. That's nice. All right. Anybody have anything to say or plug or do anything like that?
Yeah.
Yes.
What?
Yes, I have a show on the movie that I want to talk about. It's on Sunday night.
Sunday night.
Yeah.
It's
about the Dallas Cowboys cheerleaders and I.
Right.
And I want you to see it because they're really nice looking.
Oh, I'll bet they are.
Isn't that in semi-top?
That's not semi-top.
No, this is another
it's
one.
Something else
I have
then.
Something to plug, Gene.
Oh, yes, what?
Would you mind?
Other than somebody's mouth or in the neighborhood, but I have something to plug. I would say you could read about the football scores in the morning, the next morning, and the Lou Grant show is like a more important thing. That's what I have to plug.
Right.
I believe it.
I mean it.
It's a wonderful show.
Don't tell that to a football player.
Self-deluded.
Oh, dear. Now, over here, we have the completed cast of characters in our civilian contestants, Trina McKay and Sergeant Kevin Daniels. Trina's the current champ with $6,550, and she's happy about that. She's worn her mother of pearl good luck talisman all the time that she's been on the program, and she's done extremely well. And, Sergeant, how you doing?
I'm doing fine. Just a little scared.
No. Now, wait a minute. You've been around here a little while now. You shouldn't be scared. Let me touch your hands. Hands are freezing. Touch his hands. Put your hand on top of hers. Put your hand in. Put your hand on top. That's enough. Let's leave it that way. And we'll warm hands here now. All right? While you do watch his commercial, we'll warm our hands here. All right? Hello. I've been waiting for you. All right, here we go, the second round. This is the final round. Sergeant, you can have A or B.
Could I have A, please?
A, yes, sir. How long have you been in, Sergeant?
About 4 years and 4 months.
How long are you going to be in altogether?
I really don't know. It depends on how things go.
Okay. They're feeding you good?
Yeah, very good.
Pay okay?
Fairly. It's okay.
All right, you're now a corporal, just because he said that. George said, I think my father was the tidy bowl man. I know he was the tidy bowl man because when someone shakes my hand, I get blank.
I think Mr. Goodson will consider a change in cast. I've spoken to him.
Oh, you have?
There is a possibility.
Yes. Oh, really? I think the seat will be vacant.
Good. Everybody saw you cheating on the final.
Get your head.
Sad. Okay, Sergeant. George said, I think my father was a tidy bowl man. I know he was a tidy bowl man because when someone shakes my hand, I get blank.
Wet.
Wet.
Hard enough in the Air Force.
Listen, have you got bus fare back to the camp? Okay. So long, Sergeant.
Never mind, sweetheart.
Aww.
He said wet, Robert.
I know. I'm waiting for landing instructions at this moment. That's why this armed forces wouldn't take me. I said flushed.
Yeah! Flushed. You know what the tidy bowl man does,
It was back there, but I didn't.
Yeah. He's flushing right now.
But you're cute, Sergeant. Never thought I'd say that
you
to a sergeant.
You remember before when you were talking to Charles and I couldn't think of an answer?
Yeah.
Well, while you were talking to Charles, I thought of an answer. Flushed.
Flushed.
Now,
somehow
Charles
it came to her. Wet is what the sergeant said.
Oh.
Yeah.
Flush.
So we have three of those so far. What do you have down here, Audrey?
Flushed.
Flushed. Four of those. I know he was a tidy bowl man because when someone shakes my hand, I get...
Flushed.
Five of those. Yeah. Now, you got to match Patty to stay in the game and achieve a tie. Okay, Patty, show him 10.
Why do I have to be the one to do it?
You're the one. You...
You're the
one. Flushed. There you go. Six of those and Tina wins the game. Okay, Sergeant, we're going to send you some wonderful gifts, pantyhose and all kinds of great things. The guys in the barracks, you can share them with them. They're going to love you, Sergeant Kevin Daniels. Goodbye. Well, four times. Here it is again, all for the benefit of Trina McKay. Let's find out how she does this time. We polled the studio audience and said, write down your best answer to this. It ain't blank. Remember now how it goes? If you match the answer they gave most often, you get $500. For matching their second most frequently given response, you get $250. And then for matching the third, you get $100. Nothing to it, is there?
True.
Okay.
Brett.
It ain't necessarily so.
Sing it, baby.
No, don't say that, please.
Oh, all right. Okay.
Bert.
The old expression in... Ain't funny, McGee. Ain't funny. It ain't funny.
It ain't funny.
Gee, no. That's really good, Bert.
How about it?
It ain't funny.
And he's opening funny, Lake Tahoe, right?
You are familiar with how we do this.
Yeah.
Okay, no, it ain't funny.
I can
that's
do better than that.
Charles.
Maybe.
Moving right along with another winner. It ain't hay.
It ain't hay. It ain't necessarily so. And it ain't funny.
It's wonderful.
Now think carefully. You may choose one of those or give us one of your own. Trina, what's your pleasure here?
It ain't necessarily so.
You're right, I know you are.
Now, wait a minute.
This is one I'm missing.
With the juice.
Yes, one person who's going, eh. Let me hear just one of you who's in, eh, what your answer would be. Easy. It ain't easy. Oh, it ain't kosher. Let's take a look at the $100 number. It ain't right. All right.
It ain't
easy. It hasn't come up yet. But it may. I give you that much. May we see the 251, please? Well, you thought that was going to be the 500. Now what do you say?
Hey!
Hey! Hey! Hey! Hey. Wrong.
Hey, it's horses.
Slide it, Ari.
Oh!
It ain't necessarily so. You got it. Atta girl. Well, you did it, Trina. You picked the right one. You picked up another $500. You're up to $7,150 now. We're going to do a little business with America before we carry on with this game. Are you there? Yes, here we are. Are you there? Okay, Trina. Now, where are we? Oh, she just won the $500. That means the least she can play for is 10 times that amount, or $5,000. But she's going to spin the wheel now and see if she can double the money and play for $10,000 instead of $5,000. Are you ready? Have a go. Good luck to you.
Yes.
You're ready, aren't you?
I'm getting there.
Okay, he's rolling up his sleeves, and he's going to get on the same wavelength with you. And here we go. Good luck to Trina McKay. This is it. Blank stage. S-T-A-G-E. Blank stage. Blank stage. All right. Now, Robert's finished. You give us the answer that he's given. If you do that, you get $10,000. That'll give you $17,150 for a total. What do you say to that?
On stage.
On stage. The audience doesn't like that. What would you say? Backstage, some of them would say. Center stage. Well, there are all kinds of good possibilities here. She said on stage. Robert, what do you say?
That's where she is, so I should have connected. I said backstage.
Backstage. I must say, the first thing that came to my mind was backstage. I don't know why. Did you consider backstage?
The only thing I could think of was on stage.
On stage. Well, there's some logic. Here we are on stage.
That's right.
All right. You may take my hand. Here we are standing on stage here, welcoming a new player now. Here comes Almedia Brooks. Applause, applause, applause. Now we welcome you and ask you to tell us a little bit about the story of Almedia Brooks.
Oh, Almedia Brooks is incredibly nervous right now.
Okay. No, you're not nervous.
Okay, thank you. Okay, I work for the county. I'm a key punch operator.
Yeah.
I have two beautiful daughters. Alvira's 10 and Lillian is 5. I forgot.
You do remember.
Yeah. And I love swimming, jogging, sports, everything.
Good for you.
And
you're
I love
living.
Game shows.
You love game shows. Okay, good luck to you. And here we go. We'll ask you to make a decision about A or B, Almedia.
A.
A it is. Almedia. That's an interesting name.
Yours and
John. Harry said, my new economy car is so small. Instead of a hose, I wash it with a blank. Not that funny, Sam. Almedia, Harry said, my new economy car is so small, instead of a hose, I wash it with a blank.
Oh, God.
Small car.
Okay, all right. A spray bottle. Oh, a small.
A spray bottle? One of those things
yeah,
that,
you know, what you squirt like the water
with. Oh, yeah, that's not a bad idea. I don't think that's bad at all.
What do you squirt the water on with that?
What?
Yeah, you know what you know when you do the plants.
When you're doing what?
You know when you spray the water on the plants.
On the plants.
Yeah, that's.
I'm trying to get it for it.
Whatever.
I said a flower can. All my plants die, so I think you call it a flower can. Oh. I can't squeak it by those guys.
No.
Think of those awful.
You were thinking of a watering can.
Watering can.
Yeah.
That was it.
This may be a match. I mean, it's similar. It's next door to.
Get to it, lady.
It's great.
The reservations are canceled. Water pistol.
Water pistol.
That's like a. Thank you. Tell it to the judge. You better watch it, Ira.
Okay. What do you say, 16?
Juliet Prowse is available. Eyedropper.
Eyedropper is a good one. Car is so small I don't use a hose when I wash it. Instead, I use a.
That's the problem. A water gun.
A water gun.
It's a water pistol.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
This car is really small.
Teeny weeny car.
Teeny weeny car. You use a Q-tip.
A Q-tip. Got the idea now, Almedia. What do you say, Patty?
I can trade these.
First, you do it with a water pick, and then you do the
water pick. A water pick is a good one. Very good. Okay. So now you see how it goes, don't you? But it's going to get easier now. Believe me, it really will. Now we'll take a break here and do a little message for you.
Hello, Gene Rayburn.
Where is he? Oh, here he is. Yes, now let's go on with round one. Trina, you ready? This is your first one. The fairy godmother said,
yes.
I'm disappointed in Cinderella. Not only did she lose her glass slipper at the ball, she lost her blank. The fairy godmother said, I am disappointed in Cinderella. Not only did she lose her glass slipper at the ball, she lost her blank.
Virtue.
Her virtue. You say that very quietly. Speak out.
My mother's watching.
Her mother's watching. She didn't want to say virtue very loud because her mother's watching.
Virtue.
Virtue!
What's that, for heaven's sake?
Say that on television.
By the time it gets
this is
to
coming
me,
from Hollywood. Those words are never used in public. I said prince.
She lost her prince.
I tried to be right. I agree. That's what happens.
It.
happens when you try to be right.
I loved it. I don't care what they say. What do you say?
I hated it.
I'm crazy about him. He is my new best friend. I will not have them booing him.
Right.
Well,
now you must not boo him. He's the cutest little buttonless little person you ever met. What was the question?
There was no question. Just show us your answer.
Honey, between 8 and midnight, you can lose almost anything, including your innocence.
Her innocence. That should work.
I'm directing them in Tea and Sympathy. Your cindered innocence.
Your cindered innocence is another one for Tina.
Oh, my mind. The pot. Would have been.
She said, I'm disappointed in Cinderella. Not only did she lose her glass slipper at the ball, she lost her...
That's good,
well,
too.
I put, she lost her stockings, too.
She lost her innocence.
Yeah. Right.
First you lose your stockings, then you lose your innocence. Yeah, everybody knows that.
First you lose your stockings.
Close up time. Now to get
now Bert.
After the stockings and,
yes,
and we're getting warm, aren't we?
Right.
You lose your garter belt.
Uh-huh.
First you lose your stockings, then your garter belt.
Yes.
Okay, Patty, what do you say?
She's got
your skate key and your stockings.
Uh-huh. In one way, you need it. She loses your skate key and her stockings.
Her glass skate.
Patty, what are you doing?
You know, I've been trying to buy a pair of roller skates for an adult.
I've been
sniffing
this
pen. Really hard to find, because I love the roller skate. It's a marvelous sport. Almelia, what do you want here, A or B?
Let me see. A was no luck to me. I'll take B this time.
Okay. Anything you say, honey. Farmer Brown has finally lost his mind.
Uh-oh.
They just found him out in the barn, blanking the milking machine.
Here we go.
Almelia. Farmer Brown has finally lost his mind. They just found him out in the barn, blanking the milking machine.
The milking machine?
Yeah, the milking machine.
Oh, I thought milking cow. Oh, no,
Oh, now you got to start all over, huh?
Oh, my God. Filling the milking machine. Forget it. Filling the milking machine.
You mean he's trying to milk the milking machine?
Yeah, he was trying to milk the milking machine.
Well, what was that? With?
I've worked with my hands when I talk.
Oh, I see. What's that? Yeah.
No, she said feeling.
She said feeling.
She said feeling the milking machine.
Milk, you know, he have to...
Yeah, you have to feel him to milk him, don't you?
How? I can tell by the way she did that.
All right. Whatever her answer was, is what it was. What do you say, Robert?
What was it?
Feeling milking.
Feeling milking.
Feeling milking is her answer.
It's important to us. We have a lot of energy.
I'm sure feeling milking is going to come up here any number of times. Milking comes up there.
Feeling.
That's what she meant.
What are you going to do here? Okay, there's... Milking, yeah.
What else would you do to a milking machine?
Well, you could feed it some hay if you thought it mistook it for a cow.
You could never do that. I have milked a cow. I know you don't believe that. I, America, I know how to milk a cow. And I also know how to milk a machine.
That's true.
Not the last, is it?
All right, Charles.
I said making barnyard loaf.
Making barnyard loaf. That would appear to me to be the definitive answer. Making barnyard whoopee with the milking machine. All right, Audrey. Finally, Farmer Brown finally lost his mind. They found him in the barn, blanking the milking machine.
He said he was kissing.
Kissing the milking machine. That's good.
He lost his mind, right?
Well, sure, right. That's
well, if he's crazy, what's crazy about milking with the milking machine? Isn't that what you're supposed to
do? No, the cows do that, you dummy.
See, the milking machine milks the cow. He was trying to milk the machine.
He's trying to milk them. I see. Well, I think this qualifies that. I said he was fondling the machine.
Fondling the machine.
Yeah. He's milking it. Because she said feeling him.
Right. Yeah.
You didn't get it for making love, and you got it for fondling.
All right, Patty, here we go.
Exactly.
Charles and I are the same slut type people.
Making love. Okay, so here we are, 3-2 in the middle of round 2, and now we're going to do a little business with America. So pay attention, please. Thank you. Now, the next time we get together, you will see some of these people, Some of them you will not see. Some of them you will never see again. But here are the ones for next week.
Uh-oh. Nipsey Russell, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Dolly Martin, Dick Martin, and Patty Deutsch.
You were all wonderful. Thank you. Gene Rayburn here. Join us next time. 1979. Goodbye.
Match the stars from Carter Country, Richard Paul, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Joanne Harris, Richard Dawson, and Betty White as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 78. And now, here's the star of Match Game 78, Gene Rayburn.
Okay, everyone ready? First, we will all march in unison as I play the Stars and Stripes Forever. Oh, listen, let's say hello to Gloria Patterson and Sherry Hayes first. Let's do that. Now, this lady's the winner of $600 so far. And she's being challenged by Sherry Hayes. They've both had their first round question, and as you can plainly see, neither one of them is doing much of anything. But the first rounders are tough, and they'll get tougher as we go along. Here we go. Sherry Hayes, you may have A or B.
I'll try B this time, please.
B it is. This is what it says. Out of the old folks' home, old man Periwinkle said, Purvis used to be a go-go dancer. But after seeing her dance tonight, I think she's a blank-blank dancer.
Stop copying.
Old Lady Purvis used to be a go-go dancer, but after seeing her dance tonight, I think she's a blank-blank dancer.
Is that true about that suit David Frost wore those in the Nixon interviews?
This suit.
I think so.
This
it's
very
such
suit.
Such a bright suit for daytime television.
Yes. That's right. I bought it from him directly. Ah. All right, Sherry. Out of the old folks' home, old man Periwinkle said, old Lady Purvis used to be a go-go dancer. Have you ever seen a go-go dancer, honey?
Yes.
But after seeing her dance tonight, I think she's a blank-blank dancer. A go-go dancer.
A very slow dancer?
You have money for a bus ticket home, honey? Okay. She said a very slow dancer. Mr. Paul.
She was a go-go dancer.
Yeah.
Oh, but now she's a gone-gone.
Gone-gone dancer. There's one. Go back to sleep now. There.
What's the future participle of go?
The future participle of go.
You don't even know, do you?
The future.
Oh, it was a never mind. There is no answer.
Past participle.
Gone, gone.
Gone, gone. Oh, dear.
About the acting talent of you, him, and her, the critics would say all far gone, gone.
Gone, gone. I'm going to rip your scarf off. There. Okay. Joanne Harris. After seeing her dance tonight, I think she's a...
Went?
A went dancer. Go-go, went, you see, it was a play, go-go, blank-blank. You got the idea, Richard?
Went.
Went, he got the idea there. Have you got the idea?
Gone, gone.
Go-go, gone, went, all that stuff. Gloria, that puts you in the catbird seat. All you got to do is match one. Dumb Donald is so dumb. Every morning he opens a paper and reads the blank to see if his name's in it. Dumb Donald is so dumb, every morning he opens a paper and reads the blank to see if his name's in it. Gloria, Dumb Donald is so dumb, every morning he opens a paper and he reads the blank to see if his name's in it.
Obituary.
Obituary column? Have you recovered?
Mm-hmm.
Good.
Every morning I get up, and if it's not there, I'm happy.
Obit. That wins the game for Sherry Hayes. What the rest of you have? Obit. Everybody has. Let's hear it. What can I say to those spotty wood plays? Sherry, we're going to send some gifts to you. We thank you for coming in, being with us here on Match Game 78. Sherry Hayes, ladies and gentlemen, give her a hand. Here we go. We polled the studio audience, and we said, you write down your best answer to this. Blank in time. Remember, you get $500 for matching the most popular answer, $250 for matching the second most popular, and $100 for matching the third.
Betty, please.
Just in time, my father.
Just in time. There's one.
Richard, please.
Blank in time.
Well, at this point in time, I guess would be the only thing.
At
I
this
could...
point in time. All right.
Novel I'm writing.
There's two.
Charles.
All in time.
All in time. All right. So those all in time, at this point in time, and.
I read it in.
And just in time are the three. Remember, you choose one of those or give us one of your own.
Just in time.
Just in time is one Betty gave you. Let's find out if it's up there and if so where. Okay, we'll begin at the bottom and reveal the $100 response. Step in time. I don't understand that. It seems like a dumb answer to me, but that's what it says there. May we see next one, if you please. A stitch in time. It's a good one, isn't it? All right. Last chance here for just in time. Slide it if you would. Just in time, you got it. Congratulations. Another $500 for you. And you know what that means? 10 times that amount is $5,000. That's the least you could be playing for. But if you get a lucky spin on our star wheel, you could be playing for $10,000. Let's find out which player you'll be playing with and for how much. Here it goes. We all want it to stop on a double for you. Let's see if it does stop on a double this time.
Double.
It's going to stop on a double. It's going to stop on a double. $10,000 with Richard Paul. All right, good luck to you, Gloria Patterson. Let's see what happens here. $10,000. Ready?
Why me?
Here we go. Blank Garden. G-A-R-D-E-N. Blank Garden. Blank Garden. Now he's finished. We ask you to give us the answer that matches his. If you do, with whatever that answer is, you'll get $10,000 if it's correct. Blank Garden.
Vegetable.
Vegetable Garden. You got a few awes on that one, and a very small smattering of applause there. Richard?
I went the other way, flower.
Flower Garden. Rose Garden. Good possibility. I never promised you a rose garden.
True.
But you do have $1,200, and you will meet another player later after this. Hello there! Van Kohler is here. What do you know about that? Van Kohler. So you're Van Kohler.
Yes, sir.
I'm Joe. Where are you from, Van?
I'm from Iowa City, Iowa. I'm a mailman there, and my wife and son, Josh, 1.5, we have a good time there.
Yep.
Great weather.
Is your wife here?
No, she's not today. It's her birthday, and she's not here.
Oh.
She's out celebrating or doing something. I'm not sure what she's doing.
What you're saying is your wife is drunk, right?
No, my wife is pregnant. She's
what about
got morning
Josh?
Sick. He might be drunk.
Yeah, he might be drunk. Your wife is pregnant and she has morning sickness?
Yes, sir.
And that's why she's not
here? That's why she's not here. But happy birthday, Karen, anyway.
Happy birthday. She's pregnant on her birthday and she's sick. Well. You vacationing out here now?
Yes.
Snappy threads.
Thank you. Like yours, too.
Thank you. Ready to go?
Yes, sir.
All right. Tote that barge. Lift that bale. Choose A or B.
B, please.
B. Why?
No real reason.
Okay.
B for baby.
All right.
Birthday.
Ralph said.
Birthday.
Boy, did I make a mistake. Instead of sending my dog to obedience school, I sent him to karate class. Now he goes around breaking blanks in half. Kel mistake.
Oh, God.
Right.
Took a minute, you know.
Better way to go.
No, Kohler in Germany is curler. Did you know that?
Curler.
With a
half. With an umlaut over the O, curler.
Curler.
You spell it the same way, curler. Achtung, are you ready?
Yes, sir.
All right, say something when I ask you to.
Oh,
not
okay.
Yet, I not ask you to yet.
All right.
Ralph said, boy, did I make a mistake. Instead of sending my dog to obedience school, I sent him to karate class. Now he goes around breaking blanks in half. Now you say something.
Mailman.
Now, you know, if he were not a mailman, he wouldn't have said that. I read a piece once where the occupational hazard of mailmen is being bitten by dogs. And I'm sorry about that. How many times have you been bitten by dogs?
Once in 9 years.
Oh, well, then it hadn't been an occupational hazard for you.
No, not too much yet.
But you see, we didn't write this question with a mailman in mind, so I don't think any of our celebrities are going to say mailman. What do you say?
Short of that.
I have this scar right here.
Yeah, no, show us your scar.
The mailman. Sure.
Oh! Ah! He just said that to make me look foolish. Take it back. I don't accept that answer. What do you say?
Sweetheart, I'd never leave you alone and lonely and make a fool of yourself.
No.
Or an asp either. I said... Fire hydrant.
Fire hydrant, yeah.
I just... Bones.
Bones, yes.
Oh,
Well, Bone, that's all right, you know. But people, when they go to karate class, they go around breaking two-by-fours with their hands, and a dog conceivably could break a fire hydrant or a bone or...
Or a bone,
certainly. But a mailman, fire hydrant is excellent, yes.
If we'd been listening and thinking, though, we would have said that. That was very clever of you, Richard.
Yes, to say that.
But I was in the two-by-four in the wood things. I said trees.
Trees. Oh, of course. Went down and went, gave him a karate chop, and the whole tree came down, and that's it. Well, you picked up one there, which is better than none, isn't it?
Yes, one better.
Gloria, here it is. Norm said, the crabgrass on my lawn is out of control. Yesterday, it took my blank hostage. The crabgrass.
Who said that, sweetheart?
Norm. The crabgrass on my lawn is out of control. Yesterday, it took my blank hostage. Now, that one to me is difficult.
Difficult?
Yes, it's difficult for me.
I think that's an easy one, dear.
All right.
That's awful easy.
Okay, Gloria? Norm said, the crabgrass on my lawn is out of control. Yesterday, it took my blank hostage.
Wife.
Wife. Take my wife, please. And the crabgrass took his wife. What'd you say?
Lawnmower.
Lawnmower. Yep, that was the end of that.
Depends on which is more valuable to you, your lawnmower or your wife.
Well, any garden tool, I suppose.
Why does it have to be a garden tool?
Well, because of crabgrass, you know, it's out in the garden there. The tool shit is out in the grass there.
Why can't it be his wife?
I don't know.
Take off my glasses.
It's all right with me. You want to say wife, Charles?
Your glasses? Holy
Listen,
goodness.
Mr. West Bronx.
Hartford, Connecticut.
I chose bird bath.
Bird bath? Crabgrass loved the bird bath. Took it hostage. Joanne?
Yes.
What have you got there for us?
Well, I have a mower.
A mower. A lawnmower. Another garden tool.
Yes.
The crabgrass on my lawn is out of control. Yesterday it took my wife hostage.
Nope. Took the gardener.
The gardener. Fell in love with the gardener and grabbed
him. Yes, to sing.
This might be a match.
It might.
I'm not sure.
All right.
We may have to have a meeting.
We'll do the best we can.
His dog.
Dog!
Have you seen his wife?
Yes, I've seen his wife, and she is a dog, and I don't care what that says. All right, so there we are. 1-1 is a score. 1-1. Now, you will break the tie later, won't you?
Yeah.
Thank you very much. Now, would you watch this, please? Goodbye.
Today's consolation prizes are first. From Kinney Shoes, the great American shoe store, and up to the latest selection of fashion footwear, Kinney Shoes not only fit your feet, they fit your life. And an assortment of paperbacks from Warner Books featuring Stolen Rapture. Everything about Lynette was a charade except her love. Stolen Rapture by Lydia Lancaster. And Franciscan's new floral sculptures dinnerware. Gently sculpted blossoms with a blush of pastel. More patterns in white or celadon. Floral sculptures by Franciscan. And from Menon, put your hair on a high-protein diet with Protein 21 shampoo, hairspray, and conditioner from Menon. And you match the stars. Try it. Match Game 78 continues with Gene Rayburn.
Thank you, John. I'm going to ask Mark Breslow to turn on the house lights, if you would, please, Mark, because we have a group down here from Florida, and what's the name of your church?
First Presbyterian
in Fort Lauderdale, and they sing in the church, but they do other things, too, and I'm going to ask them to do two lines from Oklahoma. You ready for that? Now, you, this fella here, you do the lead. Is that it? You start... Okay. Just a couple of lines. We just want to see. Now, you do this in harmony, do you? Yeah, you all have different parts. And you have the pitch pipe? Is that okay for you? Oh. All right. Okay. That's enough rehearsal. Ready?
Behind the rain, oh, Oklahoma, every night, my honey, land that I
United States. Are you ready to carry on now? Now, for your number, you are going to sing. No, you're not going to sing at all. You're going to go to round two here. Van Curler, you may have A or a B.
I'll take B again.
B. Very good. You're okay. Weird Wanda is really weird. Not only does she sing in the shower, she blinks. Oh. Not only does she sing in the shower, she blinks. You will never make the National Leagues. Here we are, Van Curler. Weird Wanda is really weird. Not only does she sing in the shower, she blinks.
Well, I'll have to say gargles.
She gargles. Well, of course, that's the most obvious answer. She gargles?
Either that or drowns.
How can you say that?
It's either that or drowns.
What's that?
Either that or drowns.
Oh, she... Gargles or drowns?
We know we belong to the land and the...
Yes.
You don't write.
I don't. Oh, thank you don't goodness. Write.
You've been
so humiliating.
Yeah. Yes.
She not only sings in the shower, she plays the piano.
Well, there's the answer. Plays the piano.
Because she was really weird.
Weird is the word. Hello, Chuck.
You really should put the nurse back on this floor. I miss her terribly. Ever since Christmas, it's been downhill.
She... Get ready for an adorable... She water taps.
Water taps.
Water taps.
Yeah. Thank you, Steve Martin.
We know we belong to the land.
Hello there.
Hello. Not quite as adorable, but she dances.
She dances. That's what she dances. She sings in the shower, and she, you know, plays, dances, does all the goofy things you would not expect her to, but gargle.
Dances.
There's a wonderful answer. Have you got a wonderful answer also?
It may not be appropriate. I guess mailman doesn't fit here, does it?
No.
Dances.
Dances, it is. So there we are. Now, you'll have a pretty good shot at it after this message for America. All right. Well, yeah. Oh, what was that?
No, I just asked. I don't know who the original leads in Oklahoma were, which is very shocking.
I'm too young.
Who were the original leads? It was in 1943.
Joan Roberts and Alfred Drake.
That's right. Alfred Drake, who's president of the Players Club.
And they're still both wonderful and still young and handsome and singing.
Aren't we all? What was that?
Betty Gardner, Mervyn Bye.
Yes, a great show, a revolutionary show on Broadway, because it was the first time that a Broadway show used the music to motivate the plot. Don't say goodbye, I'm talking.
And I think you wore that suit to the opera.
Yes, I did indeed. Gene Rayburn here. Join us next time for whatever this is. Thank you very much.
Johnny Olsen speaking for Mets Game 78, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. This program was edited for broadcast. To match the star, Delphi Wise, Fred Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Patty DuGaston, Bill Daly, and Betty White as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game. And now, here's the star of Match Game, Gene Rayburn. Thank you.
You've never sat in this seat before, have you?
I most certainly have. I was the dummy for a long
time.
Sure
she has.
I'll get to the back of the
honey, where have you
been? I'm so used to seeing
it. When Betty's not here, I get to sit over here.
Well, excuse me.
Oh, no, no, no. You can get, no. Come back. Shane, come back. Have a seat here.
Gee whiz.
Everything's all right.
I can tell when I'm not wanted.
That's real linen, isn't it?
Happy Easter. Feel that.
You leave her copy of a Chanel suit over
there. Her copy of a Chanel suit. All right, here we have Frieda Schoenfeld and Victoria Russell. Would you give them a little applause, please? Remember, Victoria won $10,500. She's a second-year law student. Frieda is in cosmetics, and she doesn't look it, but she's 75 years old.
Sure, which I think
is tomorrow. Now, here we go. You got one shot at it. You need three to tie, four to win.
Wonderful.
The patient said, "My new doctor must really be nearsighted. He just sat on his blank."
He just sat on his.
My new doctor must really be nearsighted. He just sat on his blank. You don't play Alfie?
No.
Now let me see that question to make sure I have. My new doctor. Thank you very much.
Okay, here we go.
Yeah.
The patient said, "My new doctor must really be nearsighted. He just sat on his blank."
Stethoscope.
Stethoscope. All right. Stethoscope, she said.
Oh, sweetheart, he was more nearsighted. That was nearsighted to the point of blindness. He sat on his nurse.
Sat on his nurse, eh?
Another S.
Yes, sir, Charles?
I'll just let that one lie quietly in the laboratory. I said hypodermic needle.
Hypodermic. Hypodermic needle. All right. Now, Victoria, you must match the bottom tier completely to achieve a tie and stay in the game.
All right.
My new doctor must really be nearsighted. He just sat on his stethoscope, she said.
Scalpel.
So that means Frieda wins the game. What do we have? Scalpel.
Patience.
And patience. Okay. Now come down here, Frieda, please. Now, Victoria, we're very happy that you won $10,500. That's very nice for a second-year law student. Goodbye. Let's see, Frieda, if you can go after some of that big money. You ready?
Go do it, Frieda.
Here we go. We polled the studio audience, said, write down your best answer to this. Round of blank. You get $500 if you write to tell us the answer they wrote down most often, $250 for matching the second most popular, and $100 for matching the third. You really are 75. You're not. You're over 75.
Mm-hmm.
Wouldn't lie to us, would you?
Mm-hmm.
Well, you're amazing.
Get my driver's license with
Got
me.
Your driver's license. All right, I'll check your. All right, now you may call on three of the six for a little assistance here.
Brett. I have two. I say a round of golf.
Yeah.
There's one answer for you.
Charles?
Round of ammunition.
Round of ammunition.
Bill.
I didn't know my name quite, right? Isn't it great being a well-known star? I've been a round of drinks.
Yeah. Round of drinks. Ammunition, drinks, and golf are the three they've given you. You want one of those, or you want to dream up?
Golf.
I was going to tell you about when Anna McCurr was on.
Round of golf. You're going to go for Brett's answer.
Oh, you should have gone with me. I'm sorry.
Is there such a thing as round of golf?
Round of parties. Isn't that what they call it? They may not even
round of parties. There's another one. All right, let's find out if round of golf is up here anywhere. May we see the $100 number, if you please? There it is, right off the bat. Do you think it's going to be up there, Bill?
Oh, yes.
You should have gone with what's his name.
What's his name?
I'll never forget what's his name.
Yes. That's Bill, right.
That's Bill.
May we see the next one, please? There's Bill's answer. What do you think's on top?
Round of ammunition.
Round of what?
Applause.
Oh, applause.
I should have said it. That's what I had
round
in mind.
And round.
Why didn't you say it?
I said too free and I
I'm
changed
scared.
It to golf.
Oh, all right. May we see it, please.
I must
have
been crazy.
It is applause. Okay, enough. The $100 means at least you'll play for is $1,000. But if you spin the star wheel and get a lucky spin, you'll play for $2,000. Let's all root for a double since you didn't get a ball.
Double,
One revolution. Oh, that's pretty good.
Double, double, double.
breath. And it's going to... Just slip by the double there for a moment. Step down here again on the blue dot facing me. And here we go with Miss Brett. I'm over here.
Right. Pretty, Miss
Brett. That's it. Here we go. Chase blank. That's C-H-A-S-E blank. Chase blank. You want to take a look at it? All right. You stand right there. You all right? You want to see that? Okay. No. Now, if you give us the answer that Brett has written on the card, we'll give you the $1,000. What do you say to that?
Chase Manhattan.
Chase Manhattan. An ex-New Yorker like Brett ought to say that, huh? Yes. All right.
Nobody's really... Of course, Chase Manhattan. I don't know where my mind was. Chase Manhattan.
Now, we've got two new players coming out here. They are Marcia Nolan and Monty Brisbane. Monty Brisbane, is that what you say your name?
That's right.
Monty and Marcia Nolan. Welcome to the both of you.
Thank you.
Now, you'll both be playing two games, and this is game number one. Before we do that, let's get acquainted, find out where you're from, and a little bit about your personal life. Marcia?
I live in Seal Beach right now. I've just moved here from Berkeley a few months ago. I have a great family, and I'm a real estate agent.
Are there really seals at Seal Beach?
Yes, all over the beach.
Really?
They're wearing bikinis and swimming trunks.
Watch the eyes.
All right. Good luck anyway, Marcia. Monty, tell us about yourself, please.
Well, I'm originally from Vancouver, Canada, and I'm a flight attendant supervisor for a major airline here in Los Angeles, and I enjoy traveling and meeting and mixing with people.
You're a mixer.
Right.
All right, we got a few of those over there, too. Yes. Good luck to both of you. Marcia, you may have A or B.
B, please.
B it is for Marcia. B says, Muggsy said.
Right.
Oh, boy, this has got to be the world's toughest town. Here, even blank is considered a saint.
Now, is this Las Vegas?
This has got to be the world's toughest town. Here, even blank is considered a saint.
Oh, Muggsy's
home. See how you steal?
Steal from who? What?
From whom? And you made a mistake, too, dramatically.
Yes.
You got to watch these things.
You must call my attention right to your note or something.
If you spin the star wheel, you said, instead of when you spin it.
Correct. Absolutely correct.
These things are on my mind, and I'm up all night. For Goodson and Todman, being a company man, trying to help.
All right, Marcia. Muggsy said this has got to be the world's toughest town. Here, even blank is considered a saint.
Al Capone.
Al Capone. Good answer. Excellent answer. I would have thought she was too young to know about Al Capone.
I would have thought that, too. That's why I said the Godfather.
The Godfather.
Al Capone
why, he
was
the
Godfather?
At one time, but, you know, with
I was tell you something. Rest. I wrote Al Capone, and I thought, she's too... Listen, I really did. And I said, she cousin. And Charles is always asking me to catch up. So I wrote The Godfather. From now on, I'm going to follow my instinct.
I also wrote The Godfather.
Well, very good answer, Marcia.
Hey, boss,
but it's not working for you.
I wish I'd stuck with
it. Maybe it'll work down here.
But
who knows?
It's not a contemporary answer.
Yeah, well,
Adolf Hitler. Adolf Hitler.
I think I got a match here.
Pepper.
I got a match here in my pocket.
Yes,
light up the cigarette here. Now, I think Scarface is a match, isn't
Scarface
it?
Scarface is Al Capone.
Yeah, that was his nickname.
Right, so. You know, Bill, it seems to me you look a little too young to know about Scarface.
Oh, thank you.
And Al Capone.
Nice. Let's have dinner tonight. I'll buy it.
All right.
He's funny. You are funny.
Thank you.
Sometimes.
Very sweet.
Now, the lady with the Chanel suit on.
She wishes.
Who was Al Capone? The Godfather.
The Godfather.
Hey, I got a match here.
All right. Marcia
Boy,
picks up one.
Boy, you see some mighty pretty girls on
Monty.
A show like this. Mighty pretty.
I think he's finally flipped.
Well, it's there. My father never liked me. When he gave me swimming lessons, he made me hold a blank. My father never liked me. When he gave me swimming lessons, he made me hold a blank.
Got it.
Too ready.
I could get another kind of a job.
Yes,
I could do volunteer work.
You really don't need the money, do you?
No.
No.
It's too late for you to get out of show business. You're a star. Great to be well known. Why is Bill always the last one? Couldn't once he be the second one to the last?
Money.
Monty.
Paul said my father never liked me. When he gave me swimming lessons, he made me hold a blank.
The diving board.
Please explain to me, what does that mean?
Wait a minute, he may have a logical explanation for this.
What is it?
Well, you said...
My father never liked
me. Never liked me, right?
Yeah.
So he's teaching him to swim.
Yeah.
Right?
Right.
Well, if he's holding the diving board in one hand...
Oh, he'd go down to the bottom.
Yeah.
Oh, see, the diving... I see, now I didn't understand. The diving board was unfolded from the concrete.
Don't
it would sink to the bottom.
Alert the firing squad.
Right. Yes?
5-1, Daily matches him.
Anchor.
That's cool. That would make you go to the bottom. That's a traditional thing.
No, it should
that...
be nanker, because you said holding a...
Nanker.
It should be nanker.
Holding an anchor.
Holding an anchor.
Holding. The articles really don't count here. You make up your own articles.
Yeah, you make
sure,
them
I
up.
Make
That's
up
good.
My own.
Thank you.
I make up my own articles. I said holding a large rock.
Large rock would be like an
right,
anchor.
Baby. Right on, sweetness.
Do the same thing.
Cement block, Gene. I
cement
chose.
Block. Right. Well, anybody who says Al Capone would say that. Right. Patty?
I said a bag of cement.
Well, my father gave me swimming lessons. He made me hold a...
I said, holding his breath for an hour.
Close. It was close.
The answer stinks.
Now, he was Italian. Hold a his breath
hold
for,
his
an
breath
you
for an hour.
You should have quit with gingerbread, yeah. Boy.
Now, wait a minute. We may have a match here.
And holding his breath for an hour is a match?
No, with Miss Betty. Oh, we've moved on
from
you.
And then again, we may not.
The parade has passed you by. What do you got?
Holding a boulder.
Holding a boulder.
It was a good game.
Holding a boulder. Holding a boulder.
Hold a boulder. All right. We got another one of those duels here, haven't we? 1-0 is the score.
It's hard to get
We're going to plow on anyway right after this. Round two. Final round in this game. And, Marcia, since you're ahead, we'll ask you to go first.
Okay.
What?
Okay.
All right.
Okay.
Okay. Go ahead, Marcia. Give us an answer.
Any answer.
No, I mean, do you want A or B?
B.
Oh.
Okay. This is one of the easier games in town.
Well, that was the rumor.
We won't be sending you out to Casper.
That's right.
Plus,
you're going to graduate.
But if she was on the David Susskind program.
That's right.
That gets confusing.
Did you hear that Farmer Brown fell into the fertilizer bin?
Oh, no, what happened?
Charles question.
In one night, his blank grew 10 inches. Okay. Right.
Want to see me get off this program in a hurry?
There it is again. I just keep that one up.
Yes.
Ready. Everybody is ready, Marcia. Farmer Brown fell into the fertilizer bin, and one night his blank grew 10 inches.
His hair.
Hair grows 10 inches. The fertilizer is good for your hair. You must try it. Rub it into your scalp. It's very good for you. All right, Alfie.
Didn't you say to say the first thing that comes into your mind?
No. No. In this case, the second thing.
Keep in mind, your mother and father are coming.
Oh, I went with the second thing.
Hair. All right.
Hey, honey, fertilizer will just make your hair grow 10 inches overnight.
Right.
No, I don't like hair growing stories.
Why not, dear?
Nose.
No.
I like Italian stories about puppets and all that stuff.
Geppetto, in one night is blank retinages and hair is the answer.
No.
Nose would be the other good answer. Marsh has three.
I don't have to put one down because I got right.
That's right. You did.
Very
you
good.
Right.
Thank
round.
God.
Yes.
What a pleasure.
I should have said hair, but I blew it.
Ah. Okay.
Looks like nose was the right answer. Both people came up with it.
Now, Marty, here's the way it is. Three to tie, four to win. Here it is. Listen carefully.
All right.
Listen up.
Diane said, I'm sure that new doctor used to be an animal doctor.
Oh.
When he examined my throat, he didn't tell me to say, ah. He told me to say, blank.
Gotcha.
Gotcha.
That is the longest question I heard since I left the bar.
The new doctor used to be an animal doctor. When he examined my throat, he didn't ask me to say, ah. He asked me to say, blank.
Boy, are you a quick stuff.
I ought to do a play.
You should do
Someone
it.
Ought to cast me in a play. Someone ought to cast me in a play at the Pantages or the Huntington Hartford. Or something like
well,
that.
I'll tell someone if they come back. He wants to do a play.
Put it in.
Diane said, I'm sure that new doctor used to be an animal doctor. When he examined my throat, he didn't tell me to say, ah. He told me to say, blank.
Woof, woof.
Woof, woof. Now the question for the judge is, wait a minute, will woof, woof match arf, arf?
Or bow, wow.
Ah, you will find out. Keep tuned, and you'll find out. But first, this, no.
See if anybody has that.
Right.
He didn't tell me to say I. He told me to say bah.
Bah. Now, any animal sound here would be good.
He didn't tell me to say bah. He told me to say moo.
Moo.
Thank you.
Cock-a-doodle-doo.
We have cock-a-doodle-doo, moo. And bah-bah. This is an adult program, too.
That's right.
Those of you just tuning in.
Now, this ought to match because woof-woof and arf come from a
arf
dog.
Is good.
Right, so that's one for Marty.
Two nuts.
Got to match the next two to stand again and achieve a tie.
Sorry, I got another moo-moo here.
A moo-moo. So that means Marsha wins the game. Oh. We had an arf on that. We're going to spin this thing around and you'll go back. A little blue dot there. And you'll be back for game number two later, right? Okay, don't go too far away, Monty. Right now we're going to have a go at the big money with you, my dear. Right after we do a little business with America. Listen, you know what the honest truth is? I'm going to level with you. I come up here and I say to these friends during the commercial, listen, we got a minute to fill.
Okay.
And they all say, no, no, no.
I have nothing to plug. I haven't done anything.
Look at this.
See, look at this. Nobody wants to talk to me.
Now, look at this. This is what Jack Klugman gave her last Christmas, a diamond.
Yes.
Let me take it off.
Yes,
dear. Is it off now?
Yes, dear.
Now, this is the diamond that he gave her, and I'm going to try to put it up on the light so we can see it. See if you can see it now. Is there a light up here?
That's lovely.
He gave her that for Christmas?
Listen, I'm going to let it drop.
It's lovely. After all,
it broke in a million pieces.
Listen, that must be at least a hundredth of a carat.
Isn't that gorgeous?
Jack Klugman, you.
Look at the chain.
Oh, yes.
Bending. I think it's lovely.
John,
I'll take it.
It's
Jack,
very pretty.
It's lovely. Yes.
Can
lovely.
The nurse help me down
this
now?
Is just one of the many things.
Have we filled a minute yet? Oh, that's all we were trying to do. Oh, I thought it'd never end. Goodbye. Join us next time at the match game. Goodbye.
No sound shield for the noisy underside of your car. Not an undercoating. Polyglycol is a sound shield at new car dealers only. At American Tourist, a strong, lightweight luggage. Good-looking protection to keep your clothes looking good. American Tourist is the only way to travel. And a cosmetic tote bag and chapstick lip balm. Serious medicine to help heal and protect lips from sun, wind, and cold. Keep your lips smooth and soft with chapstick lip balm. And a planter stand and Guardsman polish used by fine furniture manufacturers. Rich in natural and organic oils. No silicones or wax buildup. And a carry-all and Buff Puff, the gentle cleansing sponge to smooth and soften your skin and let the younger you shine through. Beautiful skin begins with Buff Puff. And a manicure set and perfect nail for beautiful nails. House-hardened service coating gives nails protection from splitting and polish from chipping, furnished by Perfect Nail. And a lap blanket and Tri-Minic. Have a cold, runny nose all stuffed up. Doctors say try Tri-Minic syrup more than any other non-prescription cold remedy. Pleasant tasting and it works. Yeah. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. This program was edited and broadcast. The stars from Vegas, Bart Braverman, Rick Summers, Charles Nelson Riley, Ava Gabor, Dick Martin, and Betty White as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game. And now, here's the star of Match Game, Gene Raven.
Oh, my red. The lookalikes.
Friend came to visit you.
Thank you.
Yes.
Well, there's...
We're wearing matching ensembles there.
Oh,
isn't
sweet.
That adorable?
That's a great dog. Her name is Trotter. Some of you have met her before. She belongs to my daughter, Lynn, and she loves Betty White.
Had a haircut since the last time.
That's right. Very perceptive of you.
Smells a little less than it did.
You have to be an ensemble.
Of course. Darling, what kind of a dog is it?
It's a dog.
Oh,
it's part Labrador and part short black.
What?
Cape Cod black.
You have such a beautiful daughter.
Thank you.
How did it turn out so good?
I make beautiful babies.
You do?
That was a proposition. All right, let's greet Jamie Nicolaisen and Mark Bowes here.
Okay.
Now, you're going to play two games, remember that. And we want to get acquainted with you. Mark, tell us about yourself, please.
I'm Mark Bowes, and I'm from Bloomington, Indiana. I'm a graduate of Ligoti High School, and I'm a student at Indiana University, and I'm out here visiting friends to have a good time.
Well, that's good. What have you done that's really been enjoyable out here?
Gone to the beach.
You've gone to the beach.
That's my good time.
You don't have a lot of ocean in Indiana,
no,
do you?
No, we don't. No, we don't.
Good luck to you, Mark.
Thank you.
Jamie.
Hi. My name is Jamie Nicolaisen, as you just said. I'm originally from the San Francisco Bay Area.
Yay.
I am an aspiring singer, and I'm also production assistant for an entertainment publication in Hollywood.
All right, good luck to you, too. Now,
thank you.
The way it goes here, Mark, you have the first shot at it, and you have a choice of A or B.
B, please.
All right, here we go. Art said...
Just love that tie.
You love that tie? Charles, later
perfect.
You've got to show me how to tie it. You can tie them like that.
I was a model years ago.
Years ago.
All right, here we go with number one. Art said it's tough having horrible Hannah as a pen pal.
Bad for early.
Yeah, right. Here it is. I'm the first guy ever to get a blank through the mail. Tough having horrible Hannah as a pen pal. I'm the first guy ever to get a blank through the mail.
Well, okay. I'm in mind to the end.
All right, Mark. Art said it's tough having horrible Hannah as a pen pal. I'm the first guy ever to get a blank through the mail.
Biography?
A biography.
Hello?
Horrible Hannah. Something, you know. Well, anyway.
Okay, great.
Mark, you'll hear some good answers here, I hope.
Not necessarily.
This is one of those tough questions because you can send anything through the mail. So I tried to go at first for the obvious. I thought I would do this first to get a pen through the mail, but I didn't put that down. See?
You did.
Pen
right.
pal, pen
oh,
through the
right.
mail. But horrible Hannah.
Horrible
so
Hannah was a clue.
The first to get a zit through the mail.
There it is. Anything horrible. Anything horrible.
The first person to get a bad case of acne.
There it is. something horrible, please?
A rash, wart, and social disease.
And to think we're just getting warmed up.
Darling, you got to tell Mark that this is not a square group here.
That's
and
true.
And he's got to think on our level, which isn't very high. And as I said in my bad English and French, I kick in the derriere. You know where the derriere is?
Yes, I'm aware.
Okay,
no, would you tell us?
It's here.
Oh, it's there. Oh.
I've got the best seat.
No, she has.
What do you have for us here?
Trench mouth.
Trench mouth. Oh, that's horrible. That would be, you know, a pretty good answer there. Horrible having Hannah, horrible Hannah's a pen pal. I'm the first guy ever to get a blank through the mail. Now, what did you say?
Well, before you make fun of us professionals, I don't think biography's the swellest answer we've ever had in our lives. I said disease.
Disease, right.
Got it.
Now, Mark, I think you got the idea now. You'll do better on your second round, won't you, Mark?
I believe so, yeah.
Don't be intelligent and you'll make it.
Mel said, I think that fortune teller used to be a doctor.
Uh-oh.
Yep. She just told me my future by reading my blank. Fortune teller used to be a doctor. All right. Put it in the slot and we'll start with Jamie. Mel said, I think that fortune teller used to be a doctor. She just told me my future by reading my blank.
Thermometer.
Thermometer's all right.
That's good.
Thermometer, anything like that, it'd be good.
I wouldn't have thought of something you stick in your mouth, actually. But I said the EKG.
Your EKG, electrocardiogram. Yes, right. That's a good one.
Hey, oh, this. Yes.
Don't go, my friend.
Yes.
Actually, that's a wonderful answer, I think, because it has all those little things that go up and down.
Right.
Cardiogram
is a very good one, right.
Being raunchy and in a sports outfit, I said specimen, Gene.
Specimen.
Not all the trash is on the stage today.
Fortune teller used to be a doctor. Told me my future by reading my...
Yeah, you don't boo me. I'm very sensitive. I said the heart.
Oh, it's
the heart.
Oh,
that's wonderful. Sweet.
That's a good
one. Lovely. I think that's lovely. It's pulse.
Pulse. Another one. That would be the heart and pulse. It would be about the same thing, yes?
Well, being raunchy and dressed like my dog here in the sporting outfit, I said specimen.
Well, very cute.
So there we are at the end of round one. Now, you see, that was kind of a warm-up round. You're going to get worse as you go along. Yeah. Hang around. We got more of this coming up right after this message. We shall carry on now. Round two coming up. Score is tied. And since he went first last time, Jamie, you may go first this time.
A, please.
She says, she has a nice, deep voice.
Yes.
Very sensuous.
Not Bill where said. I'm sitting. Quiet, fella.
Deeper. Bill said, this has got to be the world's slowest ball game. World's...
Excellent.
You are all going to stay out of show business, aren't you? World's slowest ball game. Since I've been here, my blank has grown 2 inches. All right, Jamie, if you're ready. Bill said, this has got to be the world's slowest ball game. Since I've been here, my blank has grown 2 inches.
Hair.
All right. Now, apparently you're not too thrilled with her answer, which I happen to think is fairly good. You don't like that? What would you say instead of... 5 o'clock shadow?
Well, that's hair.
Hot dog.
I don't know. When's the last time you saw a hot dog grow?
How does a hot dog grow?
Hot dogs don't grow.
Oh, wait a minute.
Say that again.
I don't know if you put it in the right bun. I guess so.
Be wrong.
Be careful, the dog is here.
The cat is right. All right.
I figure, you know, you're cute, you're American, you bring your son to the game.
Right!
Your son grows 2 inches. Hey!
What about daughters?
That happens to be another good answer.
Hair, did she say?
Hair is
I
what
she
said.
I didn't say hair.
What'd you say?
I said beard.
Beard.
They don't consider that hair.
They apparently are not matching hair and beard.
Well, they rarely do where I come from.
All right.
Especially in the summer.
What do you say? Chuck.
We're still talking about the cards.
What's wrong with Bess Meyers and Arlene Francis? I mean, why can't we get one of those girls? The correct answer, Uncle Gene.
All right, sir. World's slowest ball game since I've been here. My blank has grown 2 inches. She said hair. What do you
Just
say?
Just because I know so much about football, I said hair.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
Because most sports shows have shaving cream commercials, I said beard.
You did?
Yes.
Right.
Beard.
All right. What'd you say?
Hair.
You said hair. Good for you. Now, Mark, 3-tie, 4-win. Now, everyone here, I'm sure, knows the song, Life is Just a Bowl of Cherries. We don't want you to just sing it or anything like that, but it's a well-known song. Carl the Cannibal just wrote one called Life is Just a Bowl of Blanks.
Carl the Cannibal?
Carl the Cannibal, operative phrase.
Carl the Cannibal.
Right. Already down here.
I have a tear in my right eye. Does that count?
Yeah.
Bob. Beep, beep. Lynn, you tried that very well. You have no reason to be embarrassed.
Oh, I like
way
it, but I can't do it quickly. Charles, I was amazed last time.
Doing things quickly is not always the way to do
That's
this.
True.
You don't get points for speed where I come from.
All right, Mark, here to the 3-tie, 4-win. The song, Life is Just a Bowl of Cherries. Well, Carl the Cannibal just wrote one called Life is Just a Bowl of Blanks.
Bones.
Bones. Your 3 points are not endangered whatsoever.
That's too bad.
Life is just a bowl of...
Is Bloomington where they made Breaking Away?
Yes, it is.
Great film. Lousy answer, but great film.
People.
People.
People. All the people.
Yes, ma'am?
People stew.
That's Ethel's favorite song. Life is just a bowl of cherries.
Right.
Missionary.
Missionary. Life is just a bowl of missionaries. It's a wonderful answer.
Gene, is there some way that I could go somewhere where there's more challenge?
Bones! He did it! Bones! He did it! He said bones!
Can I do password next week?
That's amazing. He matches a good answer. He matches a rotten answer. Nothing personal, Mark, but it was a rotten answer. Life is just a bowl of bones. Well,
I said people.
People. I have to match Dick and Betty to stay in a game and achieve a tie.
We were thinking of before dinner than after dinner. Bones are after dinner. People.
Right. People before dinner, so that means Jamie wins a game. And Miss Betty didn't play that round, so here we go. One if you would, please. Now, you'll be back later to play game number 2, all right? Let's swing him off now. And while we're swinging him off, we're going to pass this message your way. And hurry back to see how much money Jamie will win. Here we are with Jamie Nicolaisen. She's ready to have go with the big money, and let's see how this works out now. We polled the studio audience and said, write down your best answer to this. Blank, cabbage. $500 for you if you give us the answer they wrote down most often. If you say the answer they wrote down second most frequently, you get $250. And then for matching the third answer, you'll get $100. Now, whom do you want to call on here for a little assistance?
This is a tough choice. Bart.
I'm looking down. You're calling on me. I reverse the old phrase and say a patch of cabbage as opposed to a cabbage patch. Hey, audience. But I don't do cabbage. I don't eat cabbage. I'm not a rabbit.
Audience, you must remember, the first answer is usually very tough. The third ones are the easiest ones.
Come on, sweet.
Okay, Brett.
Corned beef and cabbage.
Corned beef and cabbage is a good one.
Kevin?
Stuffed cabbage.
Stuffed cabbage. So there you have it.
One vegan cabbage.
Stuffed cabbage and a patch of cabbage.
I'm going to go stuffed cabbage.
You want stuffed cabbage? Well, I think you're right. Let's find out how you do with stuffed cabbage.
You don't want a patch of cabbage, huh?
No patch of cabbage, no. I bet it's not up there, no how.
Hey, I think you're right.
All right. Let's take a look at the $100 response. Stuffed cabbage. I thought that was going to be up there a little bit higher.
Boiled
cabbage will be up there.
Boiled cabbage.
Red cabbage.
Red cabbage.
Red cabbage.
All right, let's see the next one, please.
Red,
red cabbage is number two.
Corned beef.
Corned beef. Corned beef. All right, go. Nice to have such a terrific, enthusiastic audience. I mean, they were calling out corned beef, and they were right. Too bad we can't do something for you. I mean, you get nothing for it. Nothing. Now, wait a minute. You're in here out of the smog and the heat, and it's air conditioned and all that,
it's so gorgeous, that's something. Outside. Thank you. More gorgeous here in Los Angeles.
You've got
today.
$100 here. That's yours. But we multiply that by 10, and that's the amount you'll be playing for. But we want you to step up here and spin the wheel. And you can grab that peg, and if it lands on a star, you'll double it and play for $2,000. Good luck. Here we go. Give it a little kick.
Why are you bullying?
You wanted a
because
double.
Because it's not a double. Is it kind of double the two?
Can't do that. No, it's $1,000. Step over here on the blue dot and face me if you would, please. And good luck to you for $1,000.
It's $5,000. Didn't she choose
corned
beef?
No, no, $1,000. Yeah, I'll run the show. Oh, you do right dances, all right? I know I'm new at it, but I'm doing the best I can. Blank aches. A-C-H-E-S. What? Blank aches.
Yeah.
Now, if you give us the answer that Betty's written on the card, you'll get the $1,000. What do you say to that? What?
Never change in midstream.
Oh, who said that? Harvey Stream.
John Wilkes Booth.
That was, all right. What do you say?
Heartaches.
Yeah! Oh. She remembers Elmo Tanner.
Elmo Tanner did the recording of Heartaches, yeah, the whistling chorus there. What do you say?
First I wrote toothaches, and then I changed it. I thought of bellyaches, and I wrote headaches. I never thought of heartaches.
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
Well, she just thought of headaches now, but headaches is an excellent answer. And you've got the $100, and you are going to play game number two, so let's get Mark Mose back here and start that process right now.
Hello, Mark.
Welcome back.
Thank you.
You ready?
Ready.
Here we go. You have a choice of A or B.
B, please.
B.
B. B.
It's got a long day here.
Ready?
Anytime.
Okay.
Oh, you can take me almost anywhere. I wondered why she was called Jolie Gabor.
Larry said, I should have known there was going to be a lot of fighting in our marriage. On our honeymoon, my wife brought along blank.
What is it, Uncle James?
Hello, you cute dog.
Hello there.
Hello.
Give her an answer.
Tell her what answer you want. This dog is 14 years old. And is as smart as anybody on this stage.
I bet that trot is a terrific walk.
Yes.
You can tell by the way she growls.
You know it.
Ready.
The dog is deaf. Do they know that?
The dog is deaf.
Very safe.
Larry said, I should have known there's going to be a lot of fighting in our marriage. On our honeymoon, my wife brought along blank.
Gloves. Boxing gloves.
Boxing gloves. What do you say to that?
Without wasting any time, boxing gloves.
Boxing gloves. One for him.
Once more into the greet show, you're
That's
right.
Two for him.
A ring.
A ring. A boxing ring.
Right.
Oh, but that was a good wedding.
That's a very good.
Yes. Oh, that was good.
Right, on too the, good. Certainly, yes.
I was square for once. I said her mother.
Her mother.
That's the definitive answer. I
That's
feel.
True. Act as a referee.
That's what I said.
A referee.
Which I think is possibly a match.
Yes, right. The two of you.
You and Bacon.
So there you are. You picked up two. You stand by for yours. Now, friends, this for you. Hello. Goodbye. We don't have time to do your question, but we'll do that next time. All right, Jamie? Listen, you were splendid.
That's beautiful. I wasn't really.
Yes, no.
Oh, you meant on the show.
Yes,
oh.
On the show, you were terrific. I look forward to seeing all of your bodies up here. And yours, too. Next time in the Match Game, Gene Rayburn, goodbye.
Some contestants will receive top security padlocks from Slaymaker. Locksmith's is 1888. Only Slaymaker padlocks have a strength rating that you match to your security needs. Maybelline Cosmetics features fresh lash mascara. 24-hour mascara that conditions while the seal's in color all day, all night. Fresh lash mascara by Maybelline. A picnic jug and Flavor Ice, America's favorite quick freeze fruit-flavored bars. 24 giant bars in the package, assorted delicious flavors. Flavor Ice, the giant cooler. Gas-saving Quaker State Sterling Motor Oil, specially blended to help save gas and money. You'll be staying on the road with Quaker State. A tray and Trident sugarless gum, the great-tasting sugarless gum with five flavors, including bubble gum. Trident for families who care about the teeth. A canister set and Boratine is formulated for the big switch to warm water washing. Now for whiter, brighter, more stain-free wash, switch to Boratine. And a calculator and Raid Crack and Crevice Sprays, unique extension wand sprays hard-to-reach places to kill crawling bugs where they hide. Bill Todman production. This program is edited for broadcast.
Squares, Peter Marshall, Brett Summers, Dick Martin, Elaine Judge, Bill Cullen, and Betty White, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game. And now, here's the star of Match Game, Gene Rayburn.
You really got them riled up pretty good there, John. Thank you, friends. Thank you for showing up. It would have been quiet out here without you. Listen.
One more time.
I'm exhausted. How tired are you?
How come you're not breathing hard? You've been breathing hard and trying to catch your breath all week.
I've been dressing with Brett.
Oh, I see. Let's say hello to Michael Ferris and Elnis Lewis over here. Briefly, let's get reacquainted once again. Tell us who you are and where you're from.
Okay, I work as a liquor manager for a supermarket. I'm from Lakewood, California.
Okay, and the mustache is real, we found out last time.
Yes, it is.
Elnis, you?
Oh, okay.
You are Elnis Lewis.
That's right.
Right.
Yes, I'm
the mother of two children.
Right, two
girls. An infant and a 14-year-old.
Right, that's right.
And her husband's name is Jerry.
Right.
And what's that?
Her husband's name is Jerry.
Right, what else do we remember about
her? Her gardenia died overnight.
Anything else?
Huh?
That's it.
Well, I think.
Well, you were not very attentive, were they? Because she said something very significant. Even I don't remember it.
I don't either.
She didn't know.
That's right. That was it. Yeah. All right. Let's carry on. Now, where are we? Oh, we're in the middle of round two. This is game one, number one. And so that means it's Michael's turn, right?
Yes, sir.
You want A or B? A. Okay, fine. Thank you very much. Here we go. Harry said, you know you've had too much to drink at the party when you try to imitate a pizza by putting an anchovy in your blank. Harry said, you know you've had too much to drink at the party when you try to imitate a pizza by putting an anchovy in your blank.
Belly button.
Belly button. Good. All right. Splendid.
It's about the size of it.
All right.
I didn't know it was that kind of party. I really didn't. I said nose.
Nose?
Put an anchovy in.
Any orifice would have been satisfactory.
I think this is a match. I said navel, and if you know a lot of people in blue navy. But it's a match. It's your definite match.
Yes, right.
It's your basic match.
I gave it the air.
All right. Now we come to you, Ms. Elaine. Imitate a pizza by putting an anchovy in your...
navel.
Navel. The blue mark, if you would please. Now, Elvis, you'll be back a little bit later to play game number two, so we're just going to swing you off and swing you on a little bit later. Now we'll have a go at Big Dough with Michael Ferris. We're swinging this board around for your benefit, the big money super match where you could win over $10,000. We polled a studio audience. Nice bunch, smart, lively group like these. Right here. And we said, write down your best answer to this. Walk like a blank. I can't tell you what I'm laughing at. But anyway, if you give us the answer they wrote down most often, we give you $500. For matching the second most popular answer, $250, and $100 for you if you match the third. All right, whom do you want to call on for a little help?
Brett.
I say walk like a man.
Yeah. All right.
Dick.
Well, I'll say walk like a woman, then.
Yes.
And I can't wait to hear the next
often.
One.
Yes.
Let's try the top row, Peter.
Oh, thanks.
Walk like a sissy.
Walk like a sissy. You can't say that. Walk like a man. Walk like a woman. Walk like a...
dog.
She's a big help, isn't she, Peter? Didn't she help you concentrate?
Walk... that's waddle like a duck, so walk like a duck. Waddle like a duck, walk like a duck.
Walk like a duck. All right, so walk like a duck, walk like a man, walk like a woman, or the three they've given you. You have a choice of choosing... choosing one of those or giving us one of your own.
Walk like a man.
Walk like a man. All right, let's take a look at the $100 response. Walk like a lady.
Uh-huh.
Oh, my mother always asked me to do that.
Yes.
Next was duck.
She failed, didn't she?
Yeah.
Come on.
All right. We never said she was a winner.
Let's take a look at the $250 response. Oh, there it is.
Walk like a duck.
Oh,
I'm going to the track.
Oh, it's
all right. Last chance for, what was it you said?
Please.
Man, I hope.
Oh, man, yes.
Oh, please.
Last chance for the man. Go. Now, that means at least you'll play for us 10 times that amount, or $5,000, but you can double it and play for $10,000. You get a lucky spin of the wheel. Have a go at it, and we'll all root for a double. Here we go. That's you.
I know it is.
We are calling on you.
Yes.
To help him earn $5,000. Good luck to you, sir. Here it is. Blank cactus. Blank cactus. C-A-C-T-U-S. Blank cactus. Mm. Well, Bill made up his mind very quickly. Now it's up to you to give us the answer that matches his to earn the $5,000. What do you say to that?
Desert.
Desert cactus. All right. I've never seen Himalayan cactus in the snow.
You haven't? We have them at home.
You do?
It's my wife's favorite plant.
Really?
All week I've been hoping they wouldn't call on me, but I'm so glad you did because desert.
Welcome back, Elnis.
Thank you.
How was it back there?
Okay.
Oh, all right. It's better to be out here, isn't it? Where you got a shot at the big dough.
Right.
Well, he's happy because he has $5,500. He really did well for himself. And now we'll start the second and final game here. And Elnis, you can have A or B.
I'll go with B.
B it is for her. This card says, Neil said, my wife is the world's worst cook. Last night, how worst was she? What is that? Wife is the world's worst cook. Last night, I broke my teeth on her blank. That's not bad. Neil said, my wife is the world's worst cook. Last night, I broke my teeth on her blank.
Biscuits.
Yeah. See, we were after something. It's conceivable that a woman could so foul up the cooking of biscuits, they should be so hard, you could break your teeth on them. We were thinking of something that you really couldn't break your teeth on. Something ludicrous.
Something like Jell-O.
Jell-O!
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, very good.
That good, though?
Excellent. Right.
He broke 32 little toffees on a chicken soup.
Chicken soup, another good response.
Grand Marnier Soufflé.
Aha!
That would be very hard, yes.
Right. Oh, excellent there.
I said any kind of soup.
Any kind of soup is fine. Bill?
Soup.
Any kind of soup. Alphabet, anything.
Soap. Any kind of Jell-O.
Any kind of Jell-O. One of those seven delicious flavors. Well, you're getting the idea, Elnis. I hope it's not going to be too late for you, honey. Michael, this is yours. Weak William is really weak.
How weak is he?
So many people have walked on him, he's getting a suit made out of blank. Here we go, Mike. Weak William is really weak. So many people have walked on him, he's getting a suit made out of blank.
Cement.
Cement. Cement mixer. Putty-putty.
How about armor?
Armor. A suit made out of armor. Well, that would protect
armor?
Him. What have you got?
Interesting that he would say cement, right?
Yes, it is interesting. It's because that's something that you walk on. That's
sure.
Why he said it.
You walk on it, you also get your suits made out of it.
Uh-huh.
I was thinking more of wipe their feet on you, as in the...
Mat?
Yes, rubber mat.
A rubber mat.
Yes.
Oh, a rubber suit. All right.
Yeah, I saw him at the wedding.
Elaine, weak William, really weak. So many people have walked on him. He's getting a suit made out of...
Concrete.
Uh-huh. Here's Michael. What do you say there, Bill Baby?
I carried it too far. Stepping stones.
Stepping stones. They stepped on him, isn't that clever?
Oh, that's clever.
He said that.
There's no saver for this one. Linoleum.
Linoleum.
Linoleum?
I said that. That was in my head.
It was hard to get a crease in the pants.
Oh, right. Yeah. But it's a wonderful answer.
Thank you, honey.
So there. Now, we'll go to the next round. This is the final round, and Michael, your head, you'll go first.
I'll take B.
All right. That means you'll have A, Elnis.
A what?
Ben said, my wife treats her new car just like a baby. Today, instead of filling it up with gas, she filled it up with blank. Let me lay you that play. Ready? I guess we're all set, Michael. Ben said my wife treats her new car just like a baby. Today, instead of filling it up with gas, she filled it up with blank.
Milk.
With milk. There are other things that
well,
babies...
Well, the definitive answer, I would say, is a pablum.
Right? Pablum.
Pablum. That's, but I said milk.
You said milk. All right.
Fortunately, I said pablum.
Ah. You said pablum. Great answer.
I would think that that would be yes. What would you fill it up with.
Yes, you sure are a smiling loser.
Easy come, easy go.
Right, sure. All right.
Right, Betty?
Right.
Now, what's going on here? Something's going on behind my back that I don't know about.
All right.
Everything. No, yes. I don't play.
You don't play.
No, but I
would. Why dance?
Do you dance?
That's right. It. I don't play.
Okay, all right. Anything you say. I'm not going to force myself on you. What do you say here?
I play.
You play?
Milk.
Milk. Uh-huh.
One for Michael.
You play, Betty.
Well, it's the definitive answer because milk gives you gas.
All right. Alice, here's the way it is. You need 5 to tie and 6 to win. It has been done many times, so think carefully now before you respond. Weird Willie is really weird.
How weird is he?
Not only can't he keep his mouth shut, he can't keep his blank shut.
Gotcha.
Really weird. Not only can't he keep his mouth shut, he can't keep his blank shut. That's it, buddy. Is really weird. Not only can't he keep his mouth shut, he can't keep his blank shut.
His fly shut.
His fly.
But that beautiful young lady said fly.
That sweet, dignified, shy, retiring young lady said fly. Fly!
I've been doing this show for many, many years, and I want you to know that's the most shocking, most terrible answer I've ever heard in my whole life.
Quite shocking, quite so.
Fly.
Fly.
Far as I find it, too. Personally, I don't find anything weird about it, but fly.
Not only can't keep his mouth shut, he can't keep his blank shut.
His garage door.
Garage door.
That's a match.
That's a match.
You got to match Bill and Betty
sure,
to stay in the
weird
game.
Willie.
What have you got there?
Oh, it loses his car.
Fly. Yeah.
Fly, yeah.
Fly before the score. All right.
Do you know, I was saying to myself, we're all weird and
real. Right.
But that nice lady would never say fly. I said eyes.
Eyes. Okay, eyes. Michael wins the game. Come on down, Michael. And take your place in the blue spot here. Now, Elvis, we're going to send some prizes your way for Match Game. Many thanks for being with us here.
Thank you.
Elvis Lewis, ladies and gentlemen. It's better off and spin a message just for you. Now, Michael, you're up here for the second time. You so far have $5,500. You could win another $5,000 or more here. Let's see how it goes. Good luck to you. We polled the studio audience and said, write down your best answer to this. Blank jams.
Oh.
Remember, it's $500 for the most popular, $250 for the second most popular, and $100 for the third. Now, look around. See who has a smart look on his or her face. Call on that person.
Elaine.
Traffic.
Traffic jams is one.
Peter. Jellies and...
Jellies and jam.
Betty.
Door jams.
Door jams.
Very good.
So you have door jams, traffic jams, jellies and jams. You choose one of those or give us one of your own.
I think I'll take traffic jams.
Traffic jams. Well, he's hoping, of course, it's going to be up there at the $500 one, but we'll start down at the bottom with the $100 response. Strawberry jams. All right, let's take a look at the next one, please. Jellies and jams is Peter's answer. Last chance traffic. For traffic jams. Traffic. Here we traffic. Go. Yeah. And
you're welcome.
At this moment, you have $6,000. Yeah. Now, you're going to play for $5,000 now. That's a minimum you can play for. However, with a lucky spin of the star wheel, you can double it and play for $10,000. You could walk out of here with $16,000 altogether. Let's see what happens. Here we go.
Brett Summers.
You are the one, Brett. You're the one. Here we go. Blank message. Blank message. Now, she's ready. If you give us the answer that she has written on that card is in the slot now, you get $5,000. What do you say?
Short message.
Short message. I don't think the audience thinks that's the right one. What would you have said, audience? I hear a variety of
answers. I would have said Garcia.
Yeah, that's right.
I thought it was a shoe-in. I said telephone.
Telephone message. Yeah, telephone. Commercial message. Telephone is a very, very good answer there. Well, I'm sorry you didn't win that, but you have an even $6,000. And
you.
That's not bad. Thank you very much. Now we've got this message for you. Thank you. Tuned. Listen, those of you who have wondered during the course of the week whatever happened to Charles Nelson Reilly, he was excused to direct an opera, I believe, in San Diego. I was trying to find out the name of it. I know he's done so many of them. He does Carmen real well and some of the others. And he's
I heard that.
The what's that?
The Fairy Queen.
The Fairy Queen?
Was
that? Yes.
I don't know whether he's ever directed that one.
You're
going to get it. He said that, really.
Roberta Peters is the one that he's worked with a lot. He's done them in New York. And
does anybody have anything to plug?
Yeah, I do.
What do you got?
Squares, all new squares from the Riviera Las Vegas.
Oh, you're working syndication, in Las Vegas.
And I produced a special. It's called The Big Band Salutes, music made famous by Glenn Miller.
No kidding.
Jimmy Dorsey with Tex Beneke and the Modern Airs and Helen O'Connell, Bob Everly. That'll be on real soon.
And do you know that Peter Marshall has eyes that are bluer than Jack Benny's?
Oh. Yeah. I know that, but I'm not going to kiss him.
Okay, no, I'll take over for you.
All right, you take over for me. I'm Gene Rayburn. Join us next time for Match Game. Thank you. Goodbye.
Some contestants will receive from Mr. Coffee a gift pack featuring America's number one coffee maker and genuine Mr. Coffee accessories, including an extra decanter and Mr. Coffee filters. And a Master Mechanic 10-gallon shop vac from True Value Hardware Stores, a combined value and personal service in over 5,000 locations nationwide. And from Kinney, a great selection of American shoe styles. Kinney's got the look you want, America. That's why Kinney's a great American shoe store. And an exciting assortment of Crayola art and activity kits with everything children need for hours of imaginative play. It's fun to create with Crayola. And from Hawaiian Tropic comes an attractive tote and Hawaiian Tropic natural tanning lotions and oils. Hawaiian Tropic, the tan of the islands. And kitchen tools. And when you want to brighten someone's day, Tootsie's got a lot of ways. Give your Tootsie a Tootsie. Tootsie Rolls, Tootsie Pops, Tootsie Pop Drops, and Tootsie Mason Mints. And a calculator and bright. Cleans and shines no wax floors in one easy step without wax. For a beautiful dynamite no wax shine, nothing shines brighter than bright. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. This program was edited and produced. Wow.
ready to match the stars. George Kennedy, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Elaine Joyce, Dick Martin, and Betty White as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game PM. And now, here's the star of Match Game PM, Gene Rayburn.
Hello, John. Thank you, friend. Thank you.
Oh, are you quite prepared?
Oh,
what? What did you have in mind?
Hi, Charles. Who is that? You brought your clack here, did you?
They're a bunch of cowboys from Oklahoma, babe.
Oh.
They all sound so butch.
Thank you very much.
Can we hear it one more time?
Hi, Charles!
Thank
you. Oh, Charles, you do have friends.
Good.
Now, only the women. Oh, okay. All right, let us greet Pam Weber here and Lieutenant Paul Strofus.
Applause, applause, applause.
Welcome to the two of you. We're a friendly bunch here. We want to get acquainted. Pam, please tell us about yourself.
Well, I guess I'm still a newlywed. I've been married for 2 months now.
Yes, you are.
I love it.
What
I
are you doing here?
Thing.
Okay.
And I'm a bookkeeper.
Yeah.
And kind of an assistant manager and kind of a buyer and kind of a lot of other little things, too. And, oh, gosh.
You're a busy lady.
Yes, I like to ski.
You do?
I love to ski. It's fun. Except when I fall down, but...
Oh, yeah, that's no fun. Falling down is no fun.
It is if you've only been married 2 months.
Gotcha. All right, Pam, good luck to you.
Thank
you. And, Paul, tell us about you, please.
I'm from Sioux Falls, South Dakota, Gene, and I spent a lot of time in Omaha, Nebraska, where I got my law degree at Creighton University. I used that degree to join the nation's largest law firm, the United States Navy JAG Corps.
Yeah.
And I'm currently stationed at the Lemoore Naval Air Station in California, up by Lemoore, California, married to my high school sweetheart. And
shall we cry? That's have a little great. Cry, friends.
No, I think it's great.
And my little boy was 6 months old this week, Matthew.
Matthew. All right. Well, Paul, that's a fascinating story. Now, where is this place you're stationed? Is it near San Diego?
No. It's up in the heart of the desolate valley. It's by Fresno, about 30 miles south of Fresno.
Oh. All right.
Oh, heaven.
Now, may I point out to you that here on Match Game PM, each of you will have three opportunities to match as many of our illustrious stars as you possibly can. And the one who's done that most often at the end of the third round will be the winner. That person will go on to play the Big Money Super Match, which can pay off over $20,000. Here we go. A or B, Pam?
Pardon? Oh, B.
B.
Yeah.
You're sure?
Yes, I'm positive.
That's a definite B,
B.
For her.
That's a B.
Selma said, at an early age, I could tell that my son was going to be a doctor. His first words were, blank.
I think the garlic smells better than that stuff that spritzed on it.
Selma said, at an early age, I could tell that my son was going to be a doctor. His first words were...
Open your mouth and say, ah.
All right. Right. What do you say to that, George?
You're looking at Elaine, it's easy.
Say, ah. Ah.
And Betty and Bradley.
Yes. What?
Is that... Put your feet in the stirrups.
Put your feet in the stirrups.
Ooh,
that's an interesting response. Charles?
Can we get Beth Meyerson? Please?
Well, no. Now, Beth is not available.
Or get Sophie Meyerson or Agnes Meyerson or
Beth
anybody. Even Max Meyerson.
Yes.
Really? You're a doctor. Please remit.
Please remit. Yes, doctors do that a lot, don't they?
Oh, boy.
Some of them make you pay in advance. Really? All right, Elaine. I could tell my son was going to be a doctor. His first words were...
take off your clothes.
You know them for what they are.
All right.
Said open wide.
Open wide. All right.
That didn't get by, did it?
No, I thought that was his open wide and say ah. Yeah. All right there, Betty.
Looks great to me, lady, but I'm the painter. No, I think all those were a lot more words than a baby would use.
Oh.
I think a baby's first words would be cough.
Cough. Yes. Turn your head and cough.
Turn your head and cough.
All right. Isn't this wonderful, Paul?
Wonderful.
Aren't you having a great time?
I enjoyed it.
Glad you came. Okay,
you bet.
That's all. Roll off. No, I'm only kidding. Here we go with his question. Unlucky Louie said, I took my wife to a wife swapping party, and just my luck, all I could get for her was a blank. All right, here we go, Paul. Unlucky Louie said, I took my wife to a wife swapping party, and just my luck, all I could get for her was a blank.
A husband.
You're just as bad as they are. You're a lawyer. You're supposed to be smart.
Well, nobody would give up their wife.
Oh. Oh.
Life right. is a...
George?
Lunch.
I said the all he could get was a rejection slip.
A rejection slip. All Perfect. Right, Brett?
He was as happy as a clam. All he could get for it was a bottle of Thunderbird wine.
A small price to pay for a wife.
I thought of a two-way lamp.
A two-way lamp.
Two-way lamp?
One of those parties, eh?
That's a switch.
Lamp that goes both ways. Uh-huh. We
oh,
heard
that's
that.
Beneath you.
Thought you'd Nothing. Sneak by, eh? All I could get for my wife was a...
Oh, an old maid.
An old maid.
I know. Yeah. I
right.
forget it.
I was thinking of Chuck's ranch, and I said an old mare.
An old mare. All I could get for her was a...
Animal lover that I am, a basset hound.
Basset hound. Yes, I'm surprised more what people didn't name dogs. Like, you know, bloodhounds, basset hounds, and beagles.
I happen to like my answer. I'm sticking with it, and I'm not changing it. What do you think of that, mister?
I didn't know they came to those parties. I thought just...
All right, so there we are at the end of round one. 1-0 is the score in her favor. We'll continue in a moment. First, we have this for you, if you please. All right, let's carry on now. We'll go to round two. Pam, you're ahead. We're going to ask you to go first.
Well, I'll stick with B.
B it is. Yeah, all right. Five people play, everyone except George Kennedy. On the far-off island, where all the people look like shoes,
I'll never get this.
Elliot was angry because his daughter snuck off with a blank. Shoes. Everyone looks like shoes. Pam has thought it over. She's ready. On the far-off island where all the people look like shoes, Elliot was angry because his daughter snuck off with a blank.
Sock.
A sock. We really weren't expecting that, were we?
Oh, dear.
They weren't expecting it either. Well, I could think of two good answers, neither of which was sock. What did you say?
No, sweetheart, she snuck off with a heel.
A heel.
I do like Charles's answer, though, in spite of that.
Why don't you talk like your own voice?
Miss? Well, I do, don't I? Talk like my own.
She's with a sneaker.
A sneaker.
Yeah.
That's
why. Heel and sneaker are the two good responses that. There. Elliot was angry because his daughter snuck off with a...
Heel.
Heel. Then after the heel, lie down, sit, roll over.
Another one would be soul, brother.
But
I said heel.
You said heel, there. What do the animal lovers say?
And another one would be loafer.
A loafer. Very good.
Fabulous.
Oh, we had some nifty ones there. Now let's see what we got for you, Paul. Hey, nobody knows this. Robin Hood was a...
I never knew that.
Yeah.
Mm.
That's why inside his little tent, he had a little blank.
better you do it.
Nobody knows. Yes. Robin Hood was a... And that's why inside his little tent he had a little blank.
Well, we don't call him that in the Navy, but I imagine he had a little John.
Yeah. Little John!
You got the idea. Yeah. Oh,
he got the idea.
Oh, isn't that wonderful?
He got the idea.
I'm ahead of him.
You got the idea. That's one for him.
Inside his tent was a little head.
You want to know something, sweetness, my adorable little person, my darling, my love? The man with the fabulous teeth and the lovely gray hair. Okay. No, inside his little tent, he had a little pole.
A tent pole to hold up the tent. A small pole.
No, not just so a pole.
Oh, all right.
Miss Piggy was in
Lieutenant,
there.
Lieutenant, is there any way we could get her on one of your boats fast?
What a lovely
slow
way to go.
Slow boat to China.
Maid Marian.
A Maid Marian, or vice versa. All right, inside his little tent, Elaine, he had a little...
John.
Little John. Yay, verily, little John.
Indeed, I said a little bow.
A little bow.
Oh, little John, you know it was right there, and I couldn't think of it. He had a little maid. She swept out and didn't do windows.
No windows. No, everything but that. All right, there we are at the end of round two. 2-1 of the score. Now, Paul, you're ahead. You have to go first.
Oh, I think I'll steal her bee away from her.
What the bee? Bee it is. At the restaurant, Henry said...
Uh-oh.
Hey, waiter, what's this fly doing in my alphabet soup? And the waiter said, he's blanking it. Here we go, Paul.
Thank you, Uncle George.
At the restaurant, Henry said, waiter, what's this fly doing in my alphabet soup? And the waiter said, he's blanking it.
I suppose he's reading it.
He's reading it. All right.
What did he say?
Lieutenant said he's reading the alphabet soup. You know, since A, B, C.
I understand reading. No wonder the Navy's in trouble. Oh, reading.
Reading. All right. What have you got?
I got a membership to the Coast Guard Auxiliary. That's what I got. One of the few men that can handle prairie and water.
Uh-huh.
I got a zero mark for that joke. Reading.
Reading. All right. Paul has 4 at this point. Dick, what have you got?
He was reading out loud. He was reciting.
Reciting.
Ah, his alphabets.
And what did you say, Betty?
Never say no to a sailor. That's what Dick Martin said, reading.
Reading. That's 5. Pam, you will need 4 to tie, 5 to win. Hey, did you hear about the mad scientist who crossed a pig with a chicken?
No! Yeah!
You'd like to hear about him, wouldn't you? Now, he has a fat, pink chicken that lays blanking eggs.
What an eggs?
Blank and eggs.
That's wrong.
I guess we're all set, Pam. This mad scientist crossed a pig with a chicken. Now he has a fat, pink chicken that lays blank and eggs.
Bacon.
Bacon and eggs. All right, she said bacon and eggs.
Well, I think it's going to be one of those things. It's going to go for your bacon or for your ham.
Ham and eggs or bacon and eggs. Got to match all the rest of them, Pam, to stay in the game.
I'm sorry, sweetheart.
Ham! So that means Paul wins the game. What are the bottom tier? Bacon, ham, ham. Come on down, Pam. I mean, I want a bigger party. Wait a minute. No, you see that. You come down. You stay. You have a seat, and we're going to roll you off. No, he takes his place on a little blue mark there, and we have some prizes for you. We're going to give you a one-way trip to Oxnard.
Oh,
I know
boy.
You're very happy with that.
Thank you.
Pam Weber, ladies and gentlemen. While she's sitting off, we're going to spin this message just for you.
Betty Boo Bye.
Here we go. All right, Paul, you ready?
Ready.
Good. You could win a lot of money here, over $20,000. Good luck to you, sir. We have 2 audience matches for you. Let's begin with this first one. We polled a studio audience not too long ago and said, write down your best answer to this vacuum blank. Remember, you get $500 for matching the most popular answer, $250 for the second most popular, and $100 for the third. And three of our six stars can assist.
Charles and I have the same love for hats. I'll take Charles.
Same love for what?
Hats. He likes hats.
I have a hat collection.
He has a hat collection. He collects hats, Charles.
Yeah, but he has hair. That doesn't make him the same kind of collector. I have no hair in a hat.
I'm losing it fast, though.
You have hair in a hat. And I'll continue this boring story in a moment. I say the fabulous vacuum cleaner.
Ah, there you got one. You want George?
George.
I would have chosen that. I'll say vacuum pump.
Vacuum pump.
All right.
And
vacuum packed.
Vacuum packed.
Packed.
All right.
That's very good.
That's vacuum one way. Packed. Yep. So you have vacuum packed, vacuum cleaner, and vacuum pump. You can choose one of those, Paul, or you can think up one of your own and use that one.
Well, my wife makes me do all the vacuuming, so I'll go with vacuum cleaner.
Yeah. Really?
You got some
smart life. Good for you.
Absolutely. Does the Navy know you push a vacuum cleaner?
They might.
Do now.
They might explain my last fitness report. I don't know.
Uh-huh. Suck it in, Paul. All right, here we go. He wants vacuum cleaner. Let's take a look at the $100 response. Vacuum the rug. That's what you do, yeah. Right?
That's what Charles does, too.
Different kind, right? Let's take a look at the next one now. Vacuum pack. All right, there was Dick's answer. Last chance for vacuum cleaner. Here we go. You got it.
Very good, Paul. One of Charles' favorites.
Now, Paul, you've won $500. That means the very least you will play for is 10 times that amount, or $5,000. But we have one more audience match for you, and we're going to multiply that result by 10, too, and see how that turns out. Here we go. Blank monkeys. Blank monkeys. All right. You may call on three again, one at a time.
Charles again.
You're very sweet monkeys.
You're on your own,
monkeys.
Hon.
This is a...
All right, the House of Monkeys.
The House of Monkeys?
Well, it's a nice bar in the valley.
Brett.
Brett. Brett who?
No. Oh, Barrel of Monkeys!
Yeah. Now, may I offer some advice?
Yes.
Brett looked over Dick's shoulder and saw that he had written on
he
the
said,
card the Barrel of Monkeys.
That might be a wasted choice then.
That's right, so don't call on Dick.
All right, Betty.
How about the Monkees?
The Monkees.
That was a group. Good
yeah,
group.
That was a singing group, wasn't it?
Yeah.
The Monkees, a Barrel of Monkees, and House of Monkees.
The Monkees.
What?
Didn't they have a television comedy show?
There was a TV show starring Anita Gillette called The Monkees, wasn't there?
Yeah.
No, I mean,
Screen
the
Monkees, Gems.
The group
Screen
of Monkees.
Gem.
David Jones.
I don't want to discuss
whatever.
It. I don't even want to be here.
What do you want here? What do you want to do here, Paul?
I'll go with Barrel of Monkees.
All right.
Good choice.
He wants a Barrel of Monkeys. Let's see if we have one up there and where, in what position. May we see the $100 monkey. Response? The Monkeys.
Yeah,
there's
monkeys,
Betty's answer.
Yeah.
The next one, please. Grease Monkeys.
Oh,
those
sure.
are mechanics. Grease Monkeys. All right, here we go with a Barrel of Monkeys. Slide it. Yeah! Very good. Very good. I thought it was going to be the monkeys up there on top position. But it was a Barrel of Monkeys, and you've got another $500. Multiplied by 10 is another $5,000. Gives you a pot of $10,000 to shoot for. But you are now going to spin the wheel. And if you get a lucky spin, you double that sum to $20,000. So get up there and grab that top peg right there. Must make one revolution. Good luck to you. Here we go.
Double it up.
Let's go for a double.
George.
Gonna be Betty.
Betty.
All right, you're playing for $10,000.
Who's it on, Betty?
It's on Betty, right. Miss Betty's going to do it for
that
you. Here we go.
So cheap, George.
Olympia blank. Oh,
I wish I had
Olympia blank.
I wish I had it.
Oh.
No question.
Now he's ready. Now to get the $10,000, you have to give us the answer, which Betty has written and put on the card in that slot. How do you fill that blank?
Well, hopefully she's taken regard of my girth and said beer.
Oh, you drink beer? He's a beer drinker. He says Olympia beer will match you for $10,000.
Darling, I'm a beer drinker, too. I'd rather it than anything, but I keep hearing the Olympia Gold commercials.
Olympia Gold.
So I said beer.
$11,000 for this fella. Tune in next week. Match Game PM will give away more money and more wonderful stars like these. Gene Rayburn, goodbye.
Some contestants will receive. Grape juices, Three Top adds pear juice for sweetness, not sugar. And a toolkit when you've got anything to stick to squeeze, reach for WD-40. It makes things work smoother, last longer. Do it with WD-40. And the polish shell system from Turtle Wax. Space age protection for your car's finish. 3 layers deep, 24 months long. The polish shell system by Turtle Wax. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game PM, a Mark Goodson, Bill Totman production.